my creatives, and welcome to another video. So today I'm here to share an art junk journal process with you, and with that I'm gonna share with you how I'm going to fix my mistake and my mess. Because I was creating something and I absolutely ruined it, and I'm gonna show you how you can fix that for yourself and give you some tips and tricks on how to do so. But first of all, I'm going to tell you what I am doing right now. So I'm working in this junk journal and I have papers in here that are not meant for mixed media. So I prepared them with some transparent gesso because I really wanted to have the magazine page as a background and the grid paper. But that will disappear, as you will see later on. So I grabbed out my watercolors because it has been a while since I used those, and I thought it would be a good background for what I wanted to do. So I wanted to draw in my art journal, but I wasn't feeling so great when I made this. So I don't know why I made the decision to draw, because my drawing is very, fed by how I'm feeling. So I wanted to draw a girl, I wanted to portray myself, and everything was okay. And then this happened. I made it too dark, things didn't go as I wanted, and I tried to fix it with some white paint, and then, no, this was a big, big, terrible mess. So I decide, well, I'm gonna grab this paint, and I'm going to paint completely over this. And now it's a big gray blob. So what I want to give you with your art journal is, if you are working on something and you don't like it, you can always start over again. And what I'm doing here is I am just going to add some gesso, and the background disappears a little. But it's all about letting go of the mistake you made, letting go of the idea you had, and just start over. So this is also not very pretty, but it gave me a clean slate, and I went to things that I know I can. So I grabbed this Dina Wakely stencil to start off, and I'm going to stencil this on both sides of my journal page to create some background and to break up that dirty gray look I got because I used some pencils and markers that weren't dry and I painted over them. And after this I thought, okay, I'm going to change my plan completely. I am going for a more relaxed something that takes less effort of me, and I'm going to make some marks and just go by it step by step. So I'm creating some marks with some brown paint. This is just some Amsterdam acrylic paint, and I'm just creating marks with my brush. I'm not thinking too much about it, and I think that's the biggest thing you have to do once you, well, messed up your page and your plan goes all gone. Do a completely different approach, because this looks nothing similar to what I was going for. And you are starting to see that this is going to be a whole new page. And that dirty gray look isn't as dirty anymore, because I added some colors that would complement it or make it look better. And I started to do collage. Collage is something that is very much in my comfort zone. I love doing collage. So I thought, I'm not going to draw anymore. Letting go of that plan, and I'm going to look at this page as a clean slate. And that is my biggest tip for you when you make a mess of your art journal page and you don't see it and you want to rip it out of your journal. I know we all had that feeling that you wanted to rip out this page and just throw it away. Don't throw it away. See what you can do with it. Paint over it, cover it up with collage, cover up the bits you don't like with collage if you are happy with certain things in on your page, and see what it brings you. So see the opportunity of what a mess can give you. And this is something I learned from doing art journaling a lot, is not to focus on the mistakes, but to see chances. I also do this in my regular life. Don't focus on what is going wrong, because I'm creating a vibe on this page right now, which I really enjoy. And maybe I'm happy that my initial plan didn't work out, because in the end, I created a page that really resonated with me and with my feelings, and really captured what I wanted it to capture. And all because I wasn't stubborn to keep with my plan. All because I was flexible and I just started over again. So you saw me adding some collage bits. I really wanted to have a neutral look, so I kept that from the original plan to keep it neutral. But instead of drawing, I decided to do collage, and I ripped up some papers and used some washi tapes. I have these stickers from AliExpress, this beautiful dragonfly that just fit my page. So I rummaged through my stash to see things that would fit and just do this very intuitive, and stopped having a plan. And sometimes that's the best thing you can do. So here I go with the washi dots, my newest obsession. And I actually really like this page. I also used some messy stamping as I was going for this messy look. Apparently I wasn't able to create something very structured, so why not embrace the feeling and let it portray on my art journal page. So I also have these beautiful washi stickers. I get these from AliExpress, and I love the flowers, and I'm just going through my stash. So if you want to know what I used, there's always a list of supplies in the description box. And if I can find it online, there are also links to products. Just be aware that some of them are affiliate links. If you want to see more of me, my social media is also linked down in the description box. I have an Instagram, a Facebook, all those kinds of things, a Pinterest. So if you are interested in seeing more, because I don't make process videos for all the things that I do, just go there and follow me on my other social media. So yeah, I'm just going for it here. I stuck this beautiful flower sticker down. I'm cutting it off, and I'm going to put the other half somewhere else on the page. I never throw these pieces away. I always add them somewhere else. And I'm going for it. I'm creating a beautiful collage look. And you can't even see on this page anymore that I made a mistake. I was so frustrated with myself, so I totally understand that. I was so frustrated. I really, really hated it because I messed it up. I messed my plan up. But in the end, I think I'm actually very happy that I did, because I love this page. It turned out great, and it turned out better than I could ever expect. So don't be afraid to create something else when you're not happy. I still also have a page from 2017 that is a big, big mess, and I never did anything on top of it. Maybe I should do that soon to show you that even though your covering up looks like a mess when you do it, it's all about the layers. So adding more layers and adding more texture, that will help you create another beautiful page. So the thing that I wanted to document is to be brave enough to heal yourself even when it hurts. Because I was hurting and I wasn't feeling great. And I was, but I wasn't. And that is what I wanted to document. But why did I feel the need to draw if it was just for me to let go of these emotions? So I think that is what I want to give you with this page. Is to not give up on your art journal page. And you can even leave them for quite some time. And sometimes all you have to do is cover it up with paint, or you can cover it up with collage, or you can rip a page out of a magazine and just stick it in there and start fresh. And see it as fresh. Walk away from it and come back to it on a later day when you feel better about creating. And then maybe you will also create something you never expected before. So I added my quote with some white Posca paint, and I did some shadowing with another pen, wrote my date on there, and then this is my art junk journal page that I want to share with you today. So I really hope that you found these tips a little bit helpful, and also that it was a bit helpful that you saw me, well, failing. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, I would love it if you would give me a thumbs up. I would also love it if you would consider subscribing to my YouTube channel. Thank you all so much for watching, and I hope to see you all next time. Bye!